Hi, I'm Dr. Danielle Fraser, and I am a research scientist here at the Canadian Museum of Nature and the director of the Beattie Centre for Species Discovery. When people think of fossils, they always think of dinosaurs first. But I would contend that there's some pretty cool, maybe even cooler, fossil mammals out there. And these might include the Brontothere and the Creodont from southern Saskatchewan. Today, when we think of Saskatchewan, we think of prairies, we think of cattle, we think of pronghorn antelope, we might even think of bison, but we don't think of relatives of the rhinoceros. And so one of the fossils that I'm going to show you today is called a Brontothere. These animals were quite large, and they lived in southern Saskatchewan 46 million years ago when it was actually a forest. There was no prairie around at that time. And these animals, they like to spend their time eating the leaves of trees, and unfortunately went extinct at the end of the Eocene. This Brontothere has these knobs on the end of its skull. These were not horns like the modern rhinoceros. They were not walking around with these horns that are made of the same material as your fingernails. Some of these animals had giant knobs that stuck out quite far from the skull. Now, we don't exactly know what they were for, but they're bigger in males than they are in females. So we can make a reasonable guess that they were fighting over females during breeding season. So this also is indicative potentially of group living in these big rhinoceros-like animals. This animal is also from southern Saskatchewan during the same time period, and it was the size of a polar bear. That's definitely something we don't expect to see in Saskatchewan today. It is a carnivorous mammal called a creodont. We know that it was a big, ferocious meat eater in part because of these huge canine teeth on the front. They're not quite as huge as a saber-toothed cat, but they're still pretty big. And this tells us that they were able to grab and hold onto relatively large prey. But unfortunately, they weren't very smart. The brain cases of creodonts are pretty small. He probably wasn't doing a lot of complex mathematics during his lifetime. Fortunately for those people who live in southern Saskatchewan, both of these creatures went extinct about 38 million years ago. In particular, southern Saskatchewan is a lot safer without polar bear-sized creodonts wandering around eating your cattle.